tell you a little bit about my background, how I got into prison ministry back in 2000. In 2000, I had a son go to prison in Wisconsin. And my brother was already in prison in Texas. And I had just got into the ministry in Hawaii. And I said, Lord, if you just send an effective witness to them while they're there, I'll go. So I started ministering in prison in Hawaii at the city county jail right there, and then at the Halaba Correctional Facilities. We go there once a month, and I started doing that, and that was my calling. I know that's where God uses me at, and I've been in prison ministry now about 17 years. Right. So when I moved here to Texas, I started out in the Hutchins unit from 2006 up until 2008, and I came over to Collin County because it was closer to home. But God, that's a ministry that is lacking. I know that everybody is not anointed to be there. You know, you got to know where you call to go. You got to know where you call, where the Lord has sent you to. You know, my ministry is not at the senior citizen home. That just ain't me. But I'll be at the prison. Amen. You know, my ministry ain't in the high schools, in the youth. I thought it was there, but it ain't. You know, I can talk to you, but I'm too rough for them. I tell it like it is. I ain't gonna hold back. Look, I gotta tell you what thus said the Lord, and hey, you gonna have to get with it, amen. Amen. So I need to say right where the prison ministry is where I've been called, and so I know God has anointed me to go into that place, those places, and tear down some walls, tear down some strongholds, and build some people up, and instill hope into those that are lost. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I've been pastor now a couple of years. Just got started. We're a small ministry. We just getting started. But you know, I thank God for what He's doing with Kingdom Application Ministries, because I know God is positioning new leaders in the body of Christ.
Right.
And He's putting people there that will listen to Him.
Right.
And do His will.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Yeah, you know, I told my mom, I said, look, you know, in the ministry, if you out of line, if you actively participating in sin, I can't use you. You can sit in the pew until you get ready to come in,
right.
Until you get ready to serve.
Right.
But if you actively participating, and I can't use you.
Yeah.
My mom said, you ain't gonna have no minutes. But you know what? I praise God, because guess what? You will not say that Kingdom Application Ministries is a church full of hypocrites.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. You won't have. That's one testimony we won't have. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because look, you up in the house, you're going to be right. You're going to get right. I got an uncle sing that song every Sunday. Get right, church, and let's go home. He sings it every Sunday faithfully.
Amen.
Down in New Augusta, Mississippi.
Oh.
Every Sunday. Everybody gets it like, oh Lord, here he goes. No, let him go. That's his ministry right now. Because when you get ready to go home, he's going to be like, didn't I remember that deacon that was there? He told you to get right for years. You ain't listened to him. Amen. Amen. So, well, we just want to get it right and go home with the Lord. Amen. Our theme today, perfecting the saints. So if you would turn with me in your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 4. I'm going to start a little bit before that, and you just read along with me here. Perfecting the saints.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm going to start at verse 7. And it says, but unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but he that also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all the heavens, and that he might fill all things. He gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith,
yes,
and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of stature of the fullness of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Father, we just thank you right now for this word, Lord, and I pray right now that you open up our hearts and minds to receive what you are saying this evening to the body of Christ, oh God. So, Father, we pray right now that you give us a heart that is good ground, Father, that your word may fall upon and plant itself, oh God. Father, that it come forth and bring forth much fruit in season. So we bless you and honor you today. In your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may take your seats. Equipping the saints. Perfecting the saints. You know, today in this information age we live in, we're full of distractions that the enemy is trying to keep us away from the gospel. He's trying to disconnect us from the truth that is in Jesus Christ.
Right.
Yeah. I'm reminded of a story in St. John, the 6th chapter, when Jesus told the disciples, unless they drink his blood and eat of his flesh, that you have no life in you.
Uh-huh.
Many of the disciples turned and walked away, but 12 remained. Jesus asked the 12, are you leaving also? And Peter responded, where shall we go? You have the words of eternal life.
Yes, yes.
We believe and are sure that you are the Christ.
Uh-huh.
We just like the 70 disciples and 58 of them walked away.
Jesus.
Because they did not understand what he was saying. And I say this because we have pastors, teachers, apostles, evangelists and prophets, they're walking away from the gospel. They're walking away because they don't understand some things. There are too many. Jesus, he told them, he said, the 12, they remain, and they remain because those were the 12 that the Father gave him. So many of us that took on the profession of being a pastor. I didn't took on the profession of being in ministry, but were you called?
Come on.
Where do you sit?
Okay.
Or did you just get up and win? I know that's bad English, but I'm gonna throw it in there. This is some call. We have to be steadfast and immovable. And one of the things that we're walking away from is because of the lack of relationship with the Father. Now, you can study the book all day long, but until you have a relationship with the Father, until you have a relationship where God speaks to you in your heart, and you respond accordingly to his word, you will not be steadfast. You will be blown away with every wind of doctrine of men. And that's why they're falling away, because they're not rooted, they're not grounded. They're looking for another profession where they can get some more money. Ephesians 4:7, he says, but unto everyone is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. The Lord gave gifts to man. He gave us gifts. He gave us the gifts of pastors, teachers, evangelists, prophets, apostles. These are the gifts that he gave to the church to help, that they may help the body of Christ grow in grace. Grace. Peter, 2 Peter 1:2 says, grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. So the gifts that God laid, the gifts that Jesus Christ gave are to teach, we are to impart, we are to tear down, we are to pluck up, we are to strengthen and edify the body of Christ, that they are not affected by by these things in this information age. And are drawn away, and they're not drawn away by their own lusts. Amen? Ephesians 2 and 5, it says, even when we were dead in our sins, he had quickened us together with Christ. He had raised us up together and made us together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come, he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Jesus Christ. For by grace you are saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. See, we're walking away because we've been boasting in our works. How many members you got?
Yes.
How many members you got? How many are saved?
Yes.
How many did you pray for this week?
Yes.
How many did you help out of a situation when they came to you?
Yes.
You know, stop right there. It's a shame when you can go get a loan from the bank faster than you can from your church. If you've been in church 20 years and you still at the same level, Second Timothy 4, he said, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall heap themselves teachers having itching ears. I'm going to stop right there. When churches need a pastor, they put out a call and they look for resumes and they see how well he speak on Sunday morning, and then they select the one that move the crowd the most. They didn't forgot to look for signs and wonders. They forgot to look to see if the Spirit of God was growing on the inside. But they just wanted somebody they could control to pay for their keeping their itching ears. You don't want to hire me as your pastor. No, not at all. Because you can't pay me for this job. You know, when I was coming along, I said, Lord, I just want to be a good assistant pastor somewhere. Just let me sit down and just help the pastor out. Uh-huh. Not so, Lord, come on now. I said, Lord, I'm 50. All these pastors you didn't call when they 30 and 35, and I'm 50. I said, Lord, why are you calling me so late in the season? Yeah. He said, because the ones that out there have no integrity. He said, I need somebody with some integrity. Where's the integrity in the house of the Lord?
Amen.
But even verse 4, he said, verse 10, he said, he that descended is the same also that ascended up far above the heavens, that he might fill all things. All things. What are those things?
Come on now.
I have to ask the question, what are those things? In Matthew 5, verse 17, he said, think not I come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Yeah.
For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from this law, till all be fulfilled.
Uh-huh.
The fulfillment of the law. So, what they got to do? I'm glad you asked. Romans 8, verse 3. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own son in the likeness of a sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Uh-huh.
We have a work to do.
Amen.
We have a work to do. He told us we have to cry loud and spare not.
That's right.
There is a work, there's holiness, and it's right. And he has given us the Holy Spirit to help us keep the law.
Amen. Amen.
He got to be dead to sin. You got to walk away from those fleshly desires and chase after the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Oh, we don't want to chase after the Spirit, though. It ain't no funny. Well, I don't know who you serve, but I love the Spirit of God. I love me some Holy Ghost. I don't know about you. We have to get to a place where we are teaching the body of Christ to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. He came to dwell with you on the inside. He said, those that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. So if I'm worshiping him in spirit, then that means his Spirit is dwelling on the inside of me. And his Spirit is not just dwelling on the inside of me on Sunday morning, but it's with me on Monday morning. It's with me on Tuesday afternoon. Where they know the Holy Ghost is dwelling on the inside. Amen. We have to preach after the Spirit. We have to teach according to the Spirit. We have to prophesy according to the Spirit. We have to live according to the Spirit. We have to walk after the Spirit. We have to teach people to walk in like Christ. Fulfilling the law that none may be lost. It's our job. That's what we're assigned to do. That's what we're here to edify and lift the body up.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, you got to put away the small things, these things that so easily beset you. Let this flesh, put this flesh aside. Try Jesus. Everybody used to say that, try Jesus.
Yes.
All right. Well, have you tried him?
Yeah.
You know, I know we're living in this microwave society. Uh-huh. And in this microwave society, we want everything to happen right now. Well, I'm sorry. God is a good God, and sometimes you got to learn how to wait on him. I remember when they said they used to tarry. I didn't grow up Church of God in Christ, but they told me they used to tarry for the Holy Ghost. But I tell you right now, we're going to have to get back to a place where you want God so much, where you want the things of God so much, that you're going to have to tarry for him. You're going to have to learn how to wait on him. You're going to have to bend your knees. You're going to have to cry out from your spirit. You're going to have to cry out from your soul. Let that be a hunger and a thirst for God. God don't show up until you hungry for him. He don't show up until you in the fire. He don't show up while you on your way. He show up when you get there.
That's it, preacher.
Oh.
All right.
It's got to be a hunger and thirst.
Yeah.
Got to be a hunger and thirst. So that if there's a hunger and thirst, now we can begin to perfect the saints. But until you are hungry, until you are thirsty, until you get away from the things of this world, these distractions are out there. And they're coming by the way of Disney even. It's crazy. You know, the movie Descendants 2 just came out. They just did a big airing of it. And the first song on there was I Am Wicked. Am I right?
Yes.
I know. I'm like, are you kidding me? And know me, wicked. You're telling you. But you know, it goes into the rest of it. But they didn't implant that in your spirit already.
Yeah.
Like, oh my goodness. Till we all come to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure and the stature of the fullness of Christ.
Yes.
We got too many baby saints in church.
Yes.
You too many baby saints in church. You can, if you cannot be in church 20 years and still only know the only Psalm 23, that's the only Psalm you know.
Come on now.
I'm sorry. That we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro. God is looking for some people that are willing to purpose in their heart to serve him.
Yes.
And I'm wondering if that's the body of Christ today.
Yes.
Is that the people with the cross outside the door? Is it the pastors and the teachers in the pulpit? Where are the people of integrity that say, God, I love you, for God I live, and for God I'll live on? Oh, you know what I said?
All right.
You ain't hear what I said. Look, I might check out this body, but I ain't dead. I'm going to live on in eternity with him.
Amen.
We cannot be tossed to and fro, carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness. Oh, they're telling you what you want to hear.
Right.
They're telling you what you want to hear, and you got itching ears, and they're feeding into it.
Mm.
He said, but speaking the truth in love,
yes.
May grow up into him all things which is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body fitly joined together. I need you.
Yeah.
I need you. We're all a part of God. I need you. The whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to effectual working and the measure of every part, maketh increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. We have to come back together.
Yes.
It's not about the numbers. If it's not about how big the church is, God will tell you when you got them 5,000, you got too many.
Come on, man.
There you go.
You got too many.
Yeah.
Get down to 300, you got too many.
Uh-huh.
I need those that are going to lay down at the altar and cry out with a brokenness of heart.
Amen.
That's going to cry out and for the sin, not only for their sin, but for the iniquities that's running rampant throughout the communities.
Yeah.
We look at these weather patterns and we say that we having bad weather. No, we got some moral corruption and we're reaping the benefits thereof. He said in Deuteronomy 30, I call heaven and earth to reckon against you today. So if you don't respond to him, then guess what? The heavens will respond. The earth will respond to his word. And they will respond according to the way we live.
Amen.
We are to equip the saints.
Yes.
If you got three saints, equip them.
That's right.
Because it will be multiplied. God is multiplying. So I tell you right now, we have to not only live after the Spirit, we have to chase after the Spirit,
yes.
We have to seek after the Holy Ghost,
yes.
And we have to tarry one for another.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Perfecting the saints.
Yes.
Amen. Shall we stand?
Thank you, Jesus.
Is there anybody here that has not accepted